A warm welcome to my today's video. Today, in my video, I will continue with the explanation of Chapter 3, Class 11, Geography, that is Interior of the Earth. Let's start with today's first topic, that is the different types of earthquakes. The first type of earthquake is the tectonic earthquake. These are generated due to the sliding of the rocks along the fault plane. The second type is the volcanic earthquakes. These type of earthquakes are mainly confined to the areas of the active volcanoes. In the areas of mining activities, sometimes the roof of the underground mines collapse, causing tremors and destructions. These are called the collapse earthquakes. The next comes the explosion earthquake. This occurs due to the explosion of some kind of chemicals or the nuclear devices. The fifth and the last is the reservoir-induced earthquake, which mainly occurs in the areas of the large reservoirs. Let's move to the next topic, that is how the earthquake events are scaled. The earthquake events are scaled either according to the magnitude or according to the intensity of the shock. The magnitude scale relates to the energy that is released during the earthquake. It is also known as Richter scale. The magnitude is expressed in absolute number, that is 0 to 10. The intensity scale relates to the visible damage that is caused by the earthquake. It is also known as Mercalli scale. The range of intensity scale is from 1 to 12. Depending upon the intensity of the earthquake, it has various effects. The first and the foremost effect is the ground and the building shaking. Sometimes, due to an earthquake, there can be some kind of short circuits which can also lead to fire. The earthquake can also lead to landslide, that is, the downslope movement of rocks and soils. If the epicenter or the fault line lies near or on the ocean floor, it can also lead to tsunami. Earthquakes sometimes also result to floods. Due to an earthquake, the water gets saturated deep inside the earth and turn it into a liquid form. This phenomena is called soil liquefaction, where the soil loses its strength and become more like a viscous liquid. One of the most disastrous effects of earthquake in the mountainous area is the avalanches. Now that was all about the earthquake. Now we'll move to our next topic, that is the volcanoes. A volcano is a place from where the ashes, magma, and different gases like the nitrogen compound, sulfur compound, and some amount of chlorine, hydrogen, and argon escape to the ground. Most of the volcanoes are extinct. Only few of them are active. A volcano is called an active volcano if the material are being released or have been released out in the past recent years. The mantle portion of the earth contains a weaker zone that is called an asthenosphere. It is from this part that the molten rock find their way onto the surface. The material in the upper portion of the mantle is called magma. Once it starts moving towards the crust and reaches the surface, it refers to as lava. There are various types of volcanoes that are found on the surface of the earth. Some of them are the shield volcanoes, composite volcanoes, calderas, flood basalt provinces, and the mid-ocean ridge volcanoes. We will study about them now one by one. The first type of volcano is the shield volcanoes. These volcanoes are mostly made up of basalt. Basalt is a type of lava that is very fluid when erupted. These volcanoes are not steep. That means they have a gentle slope. The shield volcanoes are mostly characterized by low explosivity. That means they are low explosive. However, they become explosive if somehow water gets into the vent of the volcanoes. The upcoming lava moves in the form of fountain. This is because the lava has low viscosity. Low viscosity means it can flow very easily. Thus, it throw out the cone at the top of the vent and thus it develops a cinder cone. One such example of the shield volcanoes is the Hawaii volcanoes. The next type of volcanoes is the composite volcanoes. These volcanoes are characterized by the eruptions of cooler and viscous lavas. The material that find their way to the surface are large amount of pyroclastic materials and dust. After the volcanic eruption, the material comes out and accumulates in the vicinity of the vent opening. This leads to the formation of the layers. Thus, it makes the mound appear more as a composite volcanoes. The next type is the calderas. These type of volcanoes are characterized to be the most explosive volcanoes. They are so explosive that when they erupt, they tend to collapse on themselves rather than building any tall structures. The collapse depression are called the calderas. The explosive nature of the calderas indicates that magma chamber is not only huge but is also in close vicinity with the vent opening. This is because the gravity will not allow the lava to go very high. Thus, the distance between the magma chamber and the vent opening has to be close. Fourth type of volcanoes is the flood basalt provinces. These volcanoes outpour highly fluid lava that flows for long and long distances, which can extend up to hundreds of kilometers. There can be a series of flows, with some flows attaining the thickness of more than 50 meters. The larger flood basalt provinces are the Deccan Traps from India that covers the most of Maharashtra Plateau. And the last type of volcanoes are the mid-ocean ridge volcanoes. These volcanoes mainly occurs in the oceanic areas. Sometimes, due to some tremors or earthquake, the two plates in the oceanic crust have the tendency to move apart from each other. When the two plates move apart, the magma below have the tendency to move upward, thus forming a ridge. Central portion of this ridge experiences frequent eruptions. That was all about the different types of volcanoes. Now we will move to the last topic of this chapter, that is the different types of the volcanic landforms. The volcanic landforms are of two types. First is the extrusive landforms, second is the intrusive landforms. The magma comes outside on the surface of the earth and then cools down and solidifies. The landforms such forms are called the extrusive landforms. But in some cases, this magma cools and solidifies deep inside the earth. The landforms such forms inside the earth are called the intrusive landforms. Now we will talk about some of the intrusive landforms that are found beneath the earth. The magma sometimes cools within the crustal portion and assumes different forms. A large body of magmatic material that cools deep inside the earth develops in the form of large domes. These large domes appears on the surface of the earth only after some kind of denudational or some kind of erosional process that removes the overlying material of the surface of the earth. Now, the second form of intrusive landforms are laccolith. The laccolith are also a large dome-shaped intrusive bodies, but they are not found at the base. The magma moves little bit upward and then settle down in a shape of a dome. This dome-like structure is connected by a pipe-like conduit from below. The laccolith are also regarded as the localized source of lava that find its way to the surface. In some cases, the lava develops into a saucer shapes, that is, concave to the sky body. Such landforms are called a lapolith. The next comes the phacolith. Phacolith is a wavy mass of intrusive rocks. They also have a connection with the magma chamber by a pipe-like conduit. This looks like a wavy structure. Here, the magma have the tendency to move upward and then rest in either anticline or syncline of the crest, thus giving it a wavy look structure. This wavy structure or this wavy landforms are called phacolith. Now moving to the next landform is the seals. When the lava makes its way through the cracks and move forward, sometimes it rests in a horizontal way. The horizontal bodies of the intrusive igneous rocks are called seals, or sometimes it is also called sheets. Depending upon the thickness of this material, the thinner one are called sheets, whereas the thicker one are called the seals. And the last one is the dikes. When the lava makes its way through the cracks and moves perpendicular to the ground, sometimes it gets solidifies in the same position and develop into a wall-like structure. Such perpendicular wall-like structure inside the earth are nothing but dikes. And here we come to an end of this chapter. I just hope that this video have helped you a lot in clearing your concepts. Thank you all for watching. For next chapter, stay tuned.